Hello there, this is Alexander from sciencecourse.net, and I love distortion. And today we're going to talk about a really, really great Eurorack module by Omforce called Omicide, a stereo distortion module with 37 different algorithms, different types of distortions, and each type having three different flavors, resulting in like, I don't know how many, 100. And yeah, 111,
yeah,
different flavors of distortion. This is a great module, and I really love using it with synthesizers. So when you hear distortion, your mind immediately goes to like distorted guitar riffs, and that's the reason like most people don't really use distortion for other stuff. But I think that it's a great tool to use for synthesizers, drums, and actually any type of sound. I love it. I have a ton of pedals that do overdrive, distortion, fuzz, all sorts of gain effects. And I also have a couple of modules that do that, but the Omicide by Omforce is a whole new level. So let's dive in to see all of its features and listen to a lot of sounds coming out of the Omicide module. So first, let's talk about signal flow of the Omicide. It has a stereo in and a stereo out, which is really handy. And the first thing that happened when you got a signal coming into the module is that it splits your signal into two bands, the low band and the high band, and it does not affect your lower frequencies. So the first parameter that you should tweak is the crossover knob, the X over. This fully preserves your low end, so you only have your higher frequencies being distorted. First thing is the low pass filter, that is the LPN. That means that you can kind of tame the sound before getting into the gain stages, into the distortion. I'm not exactly sure what it's doing, but it acts something like a dry wet control. For example, when you're all the way to the right, you kind of have like a fully dry signal coming out of the module. And when you start reaching noon and afterwards, you start listening to the distortion. First thing is the low pass filter, that is the LPN. That means that you can kind of tame the sound before getting into the gain stages, into the distortion. Right after the low pass filter, that is for the input, you have your gain. And right after that, you have your distortion stage that has the type and the family that we're going to talk about later, and the bias and mod knobs. The bias and mod knobs are not used for every type, for every algorithm that is in here. If you have a red light next to them, it means that they're doing something to the sound. And lastly, before getting into the output, you have another low pass filter to filter the wet signal that's coming out of the distortion. So now let's listen to some sounds and talk about the knobs. So I'm using the OP1 field for some sounds. As we discussed, the first thing that I'm going to use is the crossover knob. To start listening to the distortion. It's really sensitive to your volumes. So the gain knob adds more distortion. And for every algorithm, the bias and mod knobs are doing something. We're gonna try and listen to what they're doing for each type. Maybe not all of them, but yeah, we'll try. So as we said, you have a low pass in, So now I'm removing frequencies that I want to be distorted, and I can also shape my output. So let's briefly talk about all the types, all the distortion types that there are in this module. It has a lot of them. I think it's 37 different types of distortion. You can see the type here on this little screen. I'm not sure you can see that right now, but I'm in mode 1, which is distortion. That is kind of an analog distortion, analog emulation of a distortion. You have a soft clip, hard clip, a symmetrical wave shaper. I mean, you have a ton. You have like something like a fuzz, a crazy amount of distortion shapes and types. For example, this mode does not use the bias knob, but does use the mod knob, so you can understand where each knob is utilized. And to be honest, there are so many different types, so many different algorithms, that I don't think there's a point to talking about each and every one of them, because it's a module that invites you to listen to what you're playing, listen to what it does, and then, you know, choose your favorite one. Unless you're like a distortion and circuitry, you know, expert, it doesn't really help to talk about, you know, symmetrical and asymmetrical, you know, wave shapes and all of this stuff. What you have to know is that it has every type of distortion possible, and you can have all different flavors of distortion circuits within one module. The thing that is really important to know is that you have this switch right here that changes the behavior of each type. So let's go to the first one. Let's go to distortion, which is D, and I don't know where it is. Okay, here we go. So S stands for standard, and it's like the raw algorithm of any algorithm, any type of distortion. The X simulates like a tube amp. And lastly, O stands for odd, and this mode brings inharmonic distortions. It's really fun to use, and when you flick the switch, you will immediately hear a big difference to the sound. So let's play a sound so you can understand what every mode is doing. So here I'm at standard mode. This is your standard distortion. If I switch to the tube amp, you have a completely different sound. But my favorite one is odd, and especially in the distortion type. It brings out harmonic content and actually sounds kind of like a bit crusher, I guess. It's a really fun mode to use, and because it adds a lot to your sound, and it's my favorite of the three. So now that I have something playing, we're gonna go through the modes. the different types. It can get crazy really fast. We'll be right back. So as you can hear, is a super versatile module that can do so many things, and we just used like one melodic line, but you can use a lot of instruments, and we're gonna use some different sounds later in this demo. But yeah, it's a lot, and it's a fully featured module that can do so much stuff. And if you like distortion, and if you like, you know, gain effects for your sounds and for your synthesizers, this is the module to go. I mean, I cannot find anything that can do so many things like the Homicide. So more specifically, the mod knob is doing different things for each distortion type, and the bias knob is doing like it's kind of emulating the malfunction of recording and you know, analog circuitry for each mode in the standard and X position, the X fam. And when you're using the odd, the bias knob controls the distance between harmonics. I mean, we kind of listen to that. So let me play a sound so you can understand what it's doing. So we have this in odd mode. So now you can listen to high pitched when you're all the way to the right, and low pitched when you're all the way to the left. So you can find like your sweet spot. So the most incredible thing about the Homicide is that, yeah, it's a module, it's a Eurorack module. So you can modulate every single parameter on this module. You can even modulate the type and the fam. So you have total control and a lot of modulation options when you're using Homicide. My favorite way of using it is by modulating the type, which changes algorithms. I'm now using with this cable right here, I'm using Oct, which is an LFO by Instruo and DivKit. So I have an LFO changing the types, and it sounds incredible. By the way, I'm using the Osmos as a synth, and it sounds like this. This is incredible. By changing the types, you get all those glitches and weird sounds. So now let's try and modulate also the fam, changing by standard to X and to odd. So now I have another LFO, again from the Oct, changing the fam. I mean, you cannot do that with a distortion pedal. And that's the power of Eurorack and modular. So now I've patched the bias knob, the crossover, and mod by using this module right here. Swirl Physics by ADAC Systems, which is an incredible module for modulation because it's replicating the behavior of waves, and it actually sounds like a wave going in and out, and it's so organic and adds, you know, some movement that feels natural to your playing. So fun to do that. I mean, it's so fun playing with modulation, doing weird stuff with modules, and Amicide gives you all the options to modulate everything, which is a big plus because there are a lot of modules that only allow you to modulate a few parameters, and in this case you can do anything you want. It's a really fun way to make things interesting. So another example is, of course, drums, and for that we're going to use the KO2. So I have something going on. I'm also modulating the type. Let's add some more distortion. Yeah, things get really interesting and really crazy. It's a really fun way to play drums. Modulating the type, I mean, I feel this is the best way to use the module. It's kind of crazy, but also so, so fun. And last but not least, we have to use a guitar with this. Because, yeah, distortion and guitars are kind of, you know, interconnected. I mean, everyone has a distortion pedal for their guitar, or had one at least at some point. And yes, we're gonna use that and see how the Amicide performs with the guitar. So now we're gonna play some guitar, but I decided to get like really crazy with it. We're modulating the gain, we're modulating the crossover, and also the type with three LFOs, and things get really crazy, but yeah. It's fun, so you're not gonna listen to some typical distortion sounds, which you can do, by the way, with the Amicide, but we're gonna go a bit more experimental just for the fun of it. Pretty crazy results. So now I removed the modulation so we can listen to the to a type of to an algorithm with guitar. You can create a lot of guitar tones, and every time they sound really massive and powerful. So yeah, if you're looking for a Eurorack modular pedal board, yeah, this is your distortion. You can do so much stuff with it, and when you use modulation, maybe in a better way than I did, you can create so many different textures and weird sounds. And lastly, you have a sequencer within this module. In this mode, you just set the knob position for each step, and you can have up to 8 steps. And then by using CV or a trigger, you can plug this, the type input, and then you have a sequence going on. So right now I have a sequence already set, and I can play, and the LFO will change the steps. You can create some really interesting stuff with it. You can have like a wet dry kind of thing that you have one step dry and one step, you know, fully distorted, and you know, add this. It's a really interesting mode for this module, and it's a kind of a hidden, you know, functionality that you might not use it like all the time, but it's really fun to play with. So to wrap this up, Omicide is an incredible module. It's stereo, it has so many modulation possibilities. It allows you to modulate everything on the module, which is something that I love. It sounds incredible. It has tons of different algorithms. And yeah, overall, it's a solid, you know, module. It's not a cheap module, but at the same time, it offers you like everything you'll ever need about, you know, gain type effects. And I believe it's worth the investment if you're into this type of sound. And when it comes to myself, I really enjoy using this type of effects, but in a subtle way, and you can definitely do that with Omicide, because distortion is not only about, you know, giving a lot of volume and, you know, making everything sound nasty and gritty. It's also about giving subtle texture and increasing the harmonic content of your playing, of your sound. And since we're talking about a Eurorack module, the modulation options are pretty much endless, and you can do so many crazy stuff with it that you wouldn't be able to do with a pedal or a plugin or anything else. And that's the beauty of modular, that's the beauty of Eurorack. If you're into it, it's an expensive hobby, but I think it's so rewarding at the end. So a huge thank you to Omforce for sending this over. I really love it, and I'm not taking it off my case anytime soon. And thank you for watching and being here. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, just leave a like or subscribe, because I have a lot of things coming in the next weeks and months. And I hope to see you on the next one. Love you.